Good afternoon and welcome. And we're on behalf of the Cravey family, they are and I am, and we are so thankful that you're here today. And we appreciate you so much. And we'll, if you would, please go with me to the Lord in prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we bow in your holy presence, thanking you and praising you for your grace and mercy and great love that you have for each and every one of our lives. And dear Lord, we pray for your holy presence here in this service today as we pay tribute and honor our dear Brother John Cravey. And we thank you for him and his life and his family. And dear Lord, we just pray that you would bless in a great and mighty way. We pray that you would anoint each and every word, every song, everything that we do. May it bring glory to our blessed Savior, Lord Jesus Christ. In Christ's name we pray, amen.
I know your life on earth was trouble, and only you could know the pain. You weren't afraid to chase the devil. You were no stranger to the rain. So go rest high on your work on earth is done. Go to heaven shouting love for the Father and the Son. Oh, how we cried the day you left us. We gathered round grave to grieve. Wish I could see the angels' faces when they hear your sweet voice sing. So go rest high on that mountain, 'cause on your word to heaven a shout love for the Father and the Son. So go rest high on that mountain, 'cause son, your work on earth is done. Go to heaven a shouting love for the Father and the Son. Go to heaven a shouting love for the Father.
Well, amen, and thank you, Jordan. Dear family and friends, we're gathered here today to pay tribute to, and I don't say wonderfully, lightly, but the wonderful life of Brother John Cravey. And I've always called him brother. And if you're a man and I call you brother, that means I think you're saved. And I think you're a Christian and I think you're on your way to heaven. And I've always called Brother John, Brother John. And so anyway, I think it was like, now y'all had been at Jamestown, and thank you Jamestown, by the way. Jamestown is really here to support the service, and I know Linda and family appreciates that so much, and I do as well, having come out of Jamestown, and Brother Jack and Miss Ruth as well. But there was, and I've got to be Brother John's pastor for, I guess a year and a half now, right at a year and a half. So they were actually, Linda and Brother John, they were feeling led and compelled to, after 50 years at Jamestown, to go somewhere else. Well, they came out to Rehoboth. But when they came out to Rehoboth, I was leaving Rehoboth. And so I said, oh, I'm glad to see them, but I'm sorry they're here right now. So anyway, and so I explained the situation that, and that I had made a commitment to Haywood and was on my way there. And so Linda said, well, we'll just go on to Haywood and wait for you there. And they did. And I tell you what, and I couldn't, that was a great gift. And I said, 22 years, me and my family was at Jamestown, and that was some good years, wasn't it, Jamestown people? And I so appreciate all of you, and the Lord was blessing under Brother Brian Harrington, and we was talking about it earlier. Some of us there, seven pastors, preachers, came out from under Brother Brian Harrington. Now, that says a lot. The Lord was blessing during those years at Jamestown, and that was awesome. And for a year and a half has been Brother John's pastor. And, when I think of him, I think of consistency. He and Linda and family, and at that point in time, the children, they were faithfully committed to the Lord and to his church at Jamestown for all of those years. And that's what I saw, faithful consistency in church attendance. Hey, you were there. And that says a lot. 42 years, I didn't realize he was an engineer at the railroad. Well, that's awesome, isn't it? I knew that he had worked at the railroad and 42 years, but an engineer, and that's impressive. And then you've been married 61 years, Linda, is that right? Now that says a lot for both of them, doesn't it? No doubt, and that is so commendable. And thank the Lord for your dedication to marriage and having been married for so long and so faithful and true to each other. So, that word faithfulness comes to my mind. So, in that light and train of thought, I would like for you to consider one verse I'd like to speak to you with the Lord's help on. And I save this verse. I don't use it very often. And I use it for some Christian that has been devoted and committed to the Lord Jesus Christ. And I call it for the saint of God. Now, that don't mean that Brother John was perfect. There was only one that was perfect, right? And that's Jesus. But a saint of God is to me someone who has loved the Lord and served the Lord and walked with the Lord for a long time. And you have, Linda and John Cravey. And that's commendable. So here's my favorite verse. It's Revelation chapter 14 and verse 13. I'll read it to you. And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, write, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord. From henceforth, yea, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors and their works do follow them. Let's pray together. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. And it's a sad day. And we just pray, dear Lord, we agonize in our hearts for the tremendous loss of Brother John Cravey to his family and to his friends and to his fellow church members and former church members. But we thank you for his dedication and his commitment and his consistency in his life to love and walk with the Lord Jesus Christ. And we just pray, dear Lord, this day, as we want to pay honor and pay tribute to Brother John, we pray your blessings upon this service, each and every hurting heart and grieving heart. We just pray that you would minister as only you can, as the word says you are, O God, the God of all comfort. Please comfort is our prayer. In Jesus' name we pray together. You know, in this text, and I had wrestled with this and read this hundreds of times. And you know, but I heard a voice from heaven, John says, saying unto me, write, blessed are the dead. Blessed are, you know, I've never been to a funeral that where I was happy. And the word literally means happy, satisfied, contentment. And a perfect state of contentment that will endure through all of eternity, that's what it means. Well, I'm not happy this afternoon. You're not happy. Certainly, y'all are not happy. So, hey, who's happy? It's him. It's him. Hey, we prayed. We prayed that Brother John would get better, would be better. But let me tell you, if there's no getting no better on this side of eternity, it is better to go home and be with the Lord. If there's no getting no better, that is better in light of eternity to go home and be with the Lord. In that you see this world is not our home. We're just passing through. The Bible describes us as sojourners. And that literally means temporary residence. We won't be here. Our lives are as a vapor that appear for a little time and then vanisheth away. Even 85 years. You know, we'd have liked to have him longer. But I mean, you know, our physical bodies, as you note, get older. We can't help that, can we? And they get weaker. And they sometimes get sick and sicker and contract diseases and sometimes die. And the Word of God teaches us not only how to live life to its fullest and greatest extent, that's living for the Lord Jesus Christ. I don't believe there's any higher level of living than living for Jesus. And I've tried the alternative, and I never want to go back. But not only how to live life, but how to face death. From a Christian perspective, the Bible says, precious in the eyes of the Lord are the death of his saints. Precious to God to take a person out, one of his precious children, out of suffering and pain and agony and take him on home to be with him. It's precious in God's eyes for a person to go home and be with Jesus for all of eternity. And that's what it means. Blessed are the dead. Blessed are the dead. Blessed are not all of the dead, but blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. Now, let me tell you something. I have a responsibility to say what I believe Brother John would want me to say to his precious family, what they would want me to say, and mainly and mostly what God would want me to say. I anticipate wholeheartedly, absolutely seeing Brother John Cravey in heaven. I expect that. I believe I'll see him. I believe he'll see me, and I'll say, hey, Brother John. And he'll say, hey, Brother Phil, what took you so long to get up here? If it's long, it might not be that long. We none know, right? The Bible says we will know as we were known. You'll know him, he'll know you. From the portals of glory in heaven. So not blessed are all the dead, just those who die in the Lord. I've heard where there's a consideration, and the first thing I think of when a person goes out to eternity, did they know the Lord? It's the first thing flashes in my mind. And possibly the first thing flashes, were they saved? Were they a Christian? At that point in time, to me, that's the main question. That's all really that matters. Did they either knew the Lord or they didn't know the Lord? They're either in heaven or they're either in hell, one way or the other. And let me tell you, no one has to go to hell. Jesus died on the cross, and God placed a cross in between you and hell. But I believe John Cravey's in heaven. I believe that. And Linda, along the point of, now he didn't laugh a lot, right? No, he didn't. Now he talked. He didn't talk a lot. He was a very, mild-spirited, quiet-spirited man and a gentleman. Now he would talk to me, and he was so encouraging to me. He would tell me how glad that he he was to be there at Haywood and to be with us at Haywood, you know. And he'd tell me that just about, I'm glad we're here, would you feel? And I was so glad that, you know, and that support I felt and so appreciated that. But the day that he went home to be with the Lord, you heard him laughing. Yeah, and smiling. And so anyway, something was going on there, right? He'd not been like that before, up to the point and the time of his departure from earth to heaven, but he was laughing. I mean, you know, the Bible says, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord, which die in the Lord from henceforth, yea, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors. I tell you what, Brother John's body had gotten tired. You tell it. You see it. He had gotten weak and he had gotten feeble. And, you know, and we had prayed that the Lord would turn him around and you know, and give him a new leash on life and energy and strength. But, you know, there was no getting no better. I reinstate, if there is no getting no better, it is better to go home and be with the Lord. This earth is not our home. We're just passing through. That they may rest from their labors. And I'll close with this last part, and that is, and their works do follow them. Now, I love that. I love that. I think it's beautiful. I think it's powerful. In other words, good works for the Lord don't lead you to heaven. You don't do good works for the Lord to be saved. You do good works for the Lord because you are saved. Good works don't lead you to heaven. They follow you to heaven. So once you're in heaven, the effect and the influence, every word of encouragement he ever gave me, all of the effects and influence of your life lives on after you're gone. Now, Brother John physically, from a physical aspect, is gone. But let me tell you, his soul lives on in heaven for all of eternity. I believe that wholeheartedly. I mean, you know, hey, we might not have time to see each other and speak to each other and spend time here, but I tell you, I want him to take me fishing, you know, when we get to heaven and do some things that we hadn't had time to do. I didn't spend time with him like I would have liked to have spent, but I'll tell you what, in the hereafter, I mean, time is not a factor. Time is not a problem. You know, it's called everlasting life. That's salvation. So rich and free for a person to accept it, even to the extent that you can't work or earn or gain your way to heaven, it comes in the form of a gift. And let me tell you, the gift of salvation results in, and I love that last part, and their works do follow them. Your good works that you do or have done or will do or are doing in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ will last forever. And they don't lead you to heaven, they'll follow you to heaven. And they'll eternal reward in heaven is reward in heaven that you never, ever stop reaping the benefits of. It keeps on coming. In other words, the influence and effect of your life here on planet Earth, through your friends, through your family, whoever they were, it follows suit, it follows you to heaven. And you never, ever stop reaping the benefit. I'll tell you what, he influenced me. And he influenced many people, and certainly influenced you who are his precious family. I tell you, you know, I think and I rack my brain, you know, in a service like this, you know, Brother John, and I asked last night, you know, what would you want me to say to your precious family? What would you want me to say to them? And I'll tell you what I believe he would want me to say. If you're not saved, you need to get saved. Time's running out. Now, he lived at 85 years old, but there's no guarantee that any of us will live that long. He'd want you to know that. And I know that he loved you. And I know that you loved him. And what a great family you are. And I don't know of a family that could have done any better as far as supporting him, being with him. And I'll tell you what, he, you know, rather than and right about ready to move to the hospice house, right? But he died in your house, in his house, in their house. He bypassed the hospice house and went to God's house is what he did. Now, that's a blessing, isn't it? That's a tremendous blessing right there. You know, and so what a commendable life, what a commendable family, a career he's had. And he's been, And certainly, we're not here today to pass our last respects, for I'll never not respect John Cravey. And appreciate those 22 years that we went to church with y'all at Jamestown. We're all precious. That was us growing together. God blessing us all together. And I tell you what, those from Jamestown, we're still close-knit, aren't we? We're still close-knit. And what a privilege you've given me to allow me to be Brother John's pastor for this last year and a half.
Promised.